Hi everyone, welcome to new video from Not Real Engineering. And today's video is the fourth part in Neper tutorial series. If you did not see earlier parts, this is what we saw till now. First tutorial was just basic introduction of software Neper and how to create a basic microstructure and mesh it using Neper. Part 2 was about how to create this laminar microstructure, and that also in a controlled way. So you can see here some grains have laminar structure and some grains don't. And part 3 was about multi-scale tessellations, where you can create a tessellation first and then subdivide few grains again in smaller grains. And also on this channel I have Neper installation series. Installation process of Neper is very complicated, so I divide it into 3 parts. So if you have any question related to installation, please check out those videos. And today we are going to see how to create a microstructure which has column grains like this, and then how to visualize it and how to mesh it. Apart from columnar microstructure, there is something called bamboo morphology. So that also we will see in this video how to use that. Now I have a Windows system, so that's why I'm using this Ubuntu app, because unfortunately Neper is not available for Windows. So on left side I will show this command prompt of Linux, and on the right side I have created one folder called NRE examples, and we will solve all the examples in this folder. So first thing what you have to do is you have to go into this folder using this command line, and to do that you have to type cd/mnt, which stands for mount slash c. And once you enter the C drive, you can go to your respective folder. So in my case, I have created folder nre/example in C drive itself. So I will just say cd and nre examples. So now we are in this folder. Now let's see the Neper commands. Just to make sure if Neper is installed correctly or not, you can just type here Neper and hit enter, and then you should see this. So you can see I have version 4.2.0. So if you're watching this video way into the future, some commands might have changed. Always for latest information, you can visit this Neper website. Now these are all the commands what we have to use. As you can see here, these two commands we already entered. And now we will start with step one. First, we are going to type this command. This is for parallelization. So when you set this to 8, that means the Neper will run on 8 cores. So just copy paste that, hit enter. And then this next command is for creating tessellations. This file with all Neper commands is already available for you to directly download from this channel's GitHub profile. You can find the link in the description box below, so that you don't have to pause the video and type it. You can just download that file and then copy paste commands from here as you like. So first, let's begin with this command. Over here, /t represents tessellation module. /n represents number of grains. So we are keeping number of grains as 50. And to create column microstructure, you have to define this option /morpho and enter columnar in bracket x. Now this x means the column will be created along x direction. If you want, you can change it to y or z. /format defines the output format. Test means we will have .test file, and /o is used define the name of output file. So our output file will be columnar_polycrystal.tess. So let's enter this command. So I just copy pasted that command, and if you hit enter, it will create .tess file, as you can see here. If you open this file in notepad, it will have all the information about your tessellation, but that's not good, right? We want to visualize it. We want to have an image. For that, you have to use this next line. Now in this line, it invokes Neper's visualization module, and in this, this will be the input file. So this file we already created using this first line. And the output in this case will be an image file. Here /datacellColor tells Neper you want to color the microstructure based on what. So here we are saying ID. That means depending on grain ID, it will have different color. This next command defines the transparency. So we are keeping it 50% transparent. By /image_size, you can define the image size. Usually for publication quality, 1200 by 1200 is enough. And by /print, you can define the name of that image file. So let me copy paste this and enter. It will take some time and it will create an image file. So if I open this image file now, you can see that columnar microstructure. It is along x direction and we have number of grains equal to 50. Next step would be meshing. As of now, if you're using Neper through Ubuntu app on Windows computer, it can't perform meshing in parallel. That's why you have to define number of cores equal to 1 first and then use this meshing command. Otherwise, many times you will just get error of core dumped. This issue is there with version what I am using. Maybe in future they removed it. So first I will copy paste this command. And next you can use this command for meshing. Now over here slash m means meshing module. Again, this will be the name of input file. So the tessellation file which we generated using this tessellation module is the input file over here. Slash order defines the order of elements. So this is quadratic element. If you don't define this, that is also okay. By default, it will consider order as one. And this command let us define the mesh quality. So here I am defining mesh quality as one. Now I will copy paste this command and say enter. And now you can see here, as it is running on single core, it is very slow. It will take a long time. First, it is doing 2D meshing. Once it reaches 100%, it will start 3D meshing. And again, that has to reach 100%. So I will go and get a coffee maybe.
A few moments later.
And after 339 seconds, we have the mesh file. Again, this mesh file needs to be visualized. And for that, we will use this next command. When you are visualizing mesh file, you have to have two input files. So first is the tessellation file. And then after comma, you have to define the name of mesh file. So these are two input files. And then other commands are same as we saw earlier over here. So this is saying color based on ID, image size, and the name of image. So let's copy paste this and enter. And we have this mesh image. You can see over here, Neper will change the element size as necessary, and you will have a perfect quality mesh, which can be used to perform crystal plasticity finite element simulations. Now, another morphology which I want to talk about is bamboo morphology. And to create bamboo morphology, you just have to change this columnar word to bamboo. And it is exactly opposite of columnar microstructure. Let me show you what I mean. Again, I will make number of threads to 8 because tessellation we can do faster, so why not? And then let's create bamboo morphology. Here I am keeping number of grains as 20. And it is done. We have now bamboo polycrystal test file. Let's visualize it. For that, this command. And this is bamboo morphology. So in this, it is exactly opposite of column microstructure. When you define column microstructure in x-axis, there will be a continuous grain. And when you define bamboo morphology, it will be a plate-like grain stacked together towards the x-direction. So if you change the x-direction to y, you will get these plates oriented in this horizontal fashion. So this is column microstructure and this is bamboo microstructure. Similar to earlier case, here also you can use same commands for meshing. In this, I just removed the second order. So this will give first order elements and visualization also is same command. I will not do this in this video because as you saw, the meshing takes too much time. We have to run it on single core. So I will leave it up to you. Check the link below to get this file. If you find this video helpful, please like it on YouTube and don't forget to show your support by subscribing to this channel, which will give me motivation to create more videos. And you can check this channel's homepage where you can find many similar videos. Also, if you go to this playlist tab, here you can see the playlist of all Neper tutorials. If you're interested in crystal plasticity, I have a playlist for that as well, and some crystal plasticity software tutorials and many more. Also, you can visit channel's GitHub profile, and from here you can download all the codes which I used in different videos on my YouTube channel. You can find link of this GitHub profile in description box of this video. That's it for this video. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comment section below. And as always, thank you for watching.